And welcome back. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi met on Monday visiting Iraqi Foreign Minister Fouad Hossein. Presidential spokesman Ambassador Bassem Mradi said that during the meeting, Minister Hossein delivered the message from Iraqi Prime Minister to President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. The message stressed the importance of boosting cooperation on the bilateral level and within the framework of the Egyptian-Iraqi-Jordanian cooperation agreement. Earlier, Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry met with his Iraqi counterpart after the meeting. The two ministers held a joint press conference. Shoukry announced that a three-way meeting between Egyptian-Jordanian and Iraqi foreign ministers is to be held on Tuesday on boosting relations among the three countries. For his part, the Iraqi minister said that the talks covered cooperation on the economic and security fields. He noted that his visit aims at boosting cooperation and coordinating stances on issues of mutual concern. And for an in-depth look into today's meeting between President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and visiting Iraqi foreign minister, we're joined over the phone by His Excellency Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi, former assistant foreign minister. Good day to you, Mr. Ambassador.
Good afternoon, how are you?
And thank you very much. Your Excellency, what were the main issues discussed in today's meeting?
Everything, because we have a long experience. The relation between Egypt and Iraq, matters of security, matters of exchange of goods. As you well know, that we have a free trade area among Iraq, Egypt, and the Arab countries. We have a big community in Iraq. It reaches some days 2 million Egyptians were working in Iraq. We have the experience of the Arab Cooperation Council between Egypt, Iraq, and Jordan during the time of President of Iraq, the late President of Iraq, Saddam Hussein. So many things are on the table. Now, of course, we have a terrorist issue. We have the threat against Iraq coming from the north, Turkey, a sort of division between tribes in Iraq also. Is another issue. Many things in the field of political and security matters, in the field of trade, investment, name it, everywhere, we have many things to discuss with Iraq. Mm-hmm. Mind you that if we have the largest army in the area, then we have Syria and Iraq are very important as the two main powers, as military powers after Egypt in the Arab area.
Yes. Ambassador Bayoumi, how do you see the Egyptian-Iraqi relations and what are the main fields of cooperation between the two countries?
It was going quite well. And then we have two incidents. When Iraq invaded Kuwait, of course, it was the relation was threatened by that time. Now also the whole relation with the Arab world is threatened by the corona disease, where we cannot move easily between one of the country and the other. But I hope that we shall finish this time and start again in the fields of cooperation in many fields, whether political, security, trade, investment, and human resources also. Mm-hmm.
Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi, former Assistant Foreign Minister, thank you very much, Your Excellency, for being with us here in Panorama News. And moving on with Panorama News, where Prime Minister Dr. Mustafa Medbouli headed on Monday meeting to follow up on the implementation of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi's directives regarding the housing projects. Medbouli met with Minister of Housing, Assam al-Ghazar, to discuss a project to build 250,000 social housing units and developments in the houses for all Egyptian projects. Al-Ghazar said that the social housing fund will offer 125,000 units for booking, in addition to 125,000 units as part of the houses for all Egyptian projects in different cities. The 90, 100, 110, 120 square meters units will be available for citizens with an income of less than £9,000. In its daily report, the Ministry of Health reported 129 new cases of coronavirus and 12 deaths. The ministry said that the number of cured cases rose to 97,688 people who were all released from quarantine hospitals. And the most recent tally on Monday showed that more than 37.35 million people have been infected by the novel coronavirus globally, and